Hello and welcome to lecture number 7 for chapter Light from class 10th Physics. In this lecture, we will talk about a few more numericals which will be relatively more tricky as compared to the numericals which we have done in lecture number 6. But before I start with today's lecture, I'd like to make one correction in lecture number 6. In the second numerical that we did in lecture number 6, the height of the image that we obtained was minus 2.4 meters and not centimeters. So please make the correction. The unit of height of the image that we had obtained in question number 2 in lecture number 6 is meters and not centimeters, as the height of the object was given in meters. It was 1.2 meters. Okay, now let's proceed with today's lecture. So we'll be doing three numericals today. The first numerical is: an object 2 cm high is placed at a distance of 16 cm from a concave mirror, which produces 3 cm high inverted image. What is the focal length and the image position? So let's read it again. An object 2 cm high. So we have been given the height of the object as plus 2 cm. Positive, because the object is always placed direct in front of a mirror, is placed at a distance of 16 cm from a concave mirror. So the distance of the object is minus 16 cm from a concave mirror, which produces 3 cm high inverted image. This word inverted is important. So the height of the image is 3 centimeters, and because the question says that it is inverted, so we will have to put a minus sign in front of this because it is getting formed below the principal axis. So HI is minus 3. We need to find out the focal length of the concave mirror, and we need to find out the image position, that is V. So these are the three things which have been given by the question, and F and V is to be determined. So let us start. We have two relations. One is the mirror formula and second is the relation for magnification. So let us begin with the relation of magnification. Magnification is HI by HO, which is also equal to minus V by U. Let us see what all do we have here. So HI we need to find out. HO is plus 2. Okay, HI is given as minus 3, HO is plus 2, and then this minus sign is additional, V is unknown, and U is minus 16. So, I have substituted the value for HI, HO and U as it was mentioned in the question. Using these three relations, these three values and this relation, we have to find out the value of V. So, simple shifting and solving the fraction, you will be able to find out the value of V. And once you solve it, you will obtain V as minus 9.6 centimeters. So, please cross-check. The value for V that you will obtain will be minus 9.6 centimeters. Now, minus sign indicates that the image is getting formed on the left of the pole, left side, that is on the real side. And it was expected because it was mentioned in the question that the image is inverted. So it had to be real and inverted. Okay, the next thing that we need to find out, so we have obtained the value for V. Now we need to find out the value of F. So let us use the mirror formula now. So 1 by V plus 1 by U is equal to 1 upon F. Let us substitute. So the value for V is minus 9.6. U is minus 16 and F we need to find out. So once you solve this fraction, this LHS, the value for F which you will obtain will be minus 24 centimeters. Now minus sign indicates that the focal length is real. So you need to mention the physical significance of minus sign here. So here minus sign means that the image is virtual, and here the minus sign indicates that focal length is F is real. And we know that in case of a concave mirror, the focal length has to be real. So these are the two values. Now let's proceed to the next question. That is question number 2. So question number 2 is a little bit tricky question. So please pay attention. Okay. So the question says, an object is placed in front of a concave mirror of focal length 20 centimeter. So we have a concave mirror and focal length is 20. So in case of a concave mirror, the focal length is negative. The image formed is 3 times the size of the object. So basically, the ratio of HI upon HO is given to be 3, which we know is also equal to the magnification. Okay, so magnification to us is given to us is 3. Find 2 possible object distances from the mirror. Now remember, just like U, V, F, H, I and H, O, magnification also follows its sign convention. When the image formed is virtual erect, the magnification is positive, and when the image formed is real and inverted, magnification is negative. Now in this question, it is not mentioned whether the image formed is inverted or erect, whether it is real or virtual. It simply says that the image is 3 times magnified or 3 times bigger as compared to the size of the object. Now, in case of a concave mirror, you have to remember that a magnified image is formed on the real side also. And we have one case when the object is placed between F and P, a magnified image is formed on the virtual side also. So, as the question does not specify whether we have to solve for real or virtual, so we'll have to solve for both the cases here. So let us begin. So focal length is minus 20. So let's do it for 2 cases separately then. Okay. So this side we will talk about a real image and this side we will talk about the virtual image. Real magnified and virtual magnified. So F is minus 20. In case of a real image, magnification is negative. So M is minus 3. Okay. Let's write the given entities for virtual case also. So focal length here is minus 20. Focal length of a mirror never changes. So focal length is still minus 20 for concave mirror. But because we are talking about the virtual image, magnification here will be plus 3. Fine. And magnification has no units. So I have not mentioned any unit for magnification. Now let's continue. We know that magnification is also equal to minus V by U. Fine. So we can say that minus V by U is equal to minus 3 or V is equal to 3U. Now let us use the mirror formula. 1 by F is equal to 1 by V plus 1 by U. Now in this case, we have the value for F, but V and U both are unknown. So what we can do here is we can substitute V as 3U. So we will get 1 by F is equal to 1 upon 3U plus 1 upon U. I have simply substituted 3U in place of V because we had obtained this relation here. Fine. Now the value for F is minus 20, this is 3u and this is u. I will not be giving you the, I will not be solving the whole thing, I will just give you the final answer, you can solve and check. So now from in this relation we can see that u is the unknown variable, a single unknown variable. So using this we can find out the value for u. So the object distance or object position with respect to the pole of the concave mirror when the image is real and magnified. I'll write magnified also here. Okay. Now, let us talk about the virtual case. So, F is minus 20 and magnification is plus 3 now. Again, using the same approach, we know that magnification is also minus V by U. This implies that minus V by U is equal to plus 3, or from here I can say that V is equal to minus of 3U. Remember in this case the relation was V is equal to plus 3U. Okay. Again, mirror formula gives us this relation, 1 by V is equal to, 1 by F is equal to 1 by V plus 1 by U. Substitute the value, F is minus 20, V is minus 3U. Again, in this case, now initially we had two unknown variables, V and U, F was given in the question. But now we have only a single variable, that is U. So once again you shift and solve and you will be able to get a value for U. Fine. So I'll just give you the results. You have to solve and check. The two possible values for object distance will be minus 40 upon 3 centimeter and minus 80 upon 3 centimeter. I'll just write the answer here. The two possible answers are minus 40 by 3 centimeter and minus 80 by 3 centimeter. Okay, so please just solve and check which one is which. Okay, so I hope you've understood why we have done two cases in this question. Now let's do the third question, another very important question based on spherical mirrors. So the third question is based on two magnifications. Let us see how. Okay, when an object is placed at a distance of 60 centimeter from a convex spherical mirror. Remember, the mirror is convex now. So focal length, radius of curvature, everything will be virtual. The image also will be virtual. Anyway, so when the object is placed at a distance of 60 centimeter, so U given to us is minus 60 centimeter. From a convex spherical mirror, the magnification produced is half. Now, as I told you in the previous question, that is question number 2 of this lecture only, that magnification also has its own sign convention. When the image is virtual, magnification is positive. When the image is real, magnification is negative. In case of a convex mirror, the image formed is always virtual and erect. So, in this case, we clearly know that magnification is plus half. Okay. The magnification is half. Where should the object be placed to get a magnification of 1 by 3? We'll talk about the magnification 1 by 3 later on. Let us see what all we can find out with this information. So magnification is 1 by 2 and we know that magnification is also equal to minus V by U. Hence minus V by U is 1 by 2. Now U is minus 60. So V is equal to 60 by 2, that is 30 centimeters. And V is coming out to be positive, which was expected because the image is virtual and erect in case of a convex mirror. So V is 30 centimeters. Now we have V, we have the value of U. Let us find out F with the help of the mirror formula. So 1 by F is equal to 1 by V plus 1 by U. So 1 upon F is equal to, the value for V is 30. And the value of U is minus 60. LCM of these two will be 60. So what will you get? Here you will get 2 minus 1, that is 1 by 60. So 1 by F is coming out to be 1 by 60, which implies that, I'll continue it here. So this implies that F is plus 60. Once again, the focal length is coming out to be positive and we know that the focal length for a convex mirror is virtual on the right side of the mirror. So this is correct. So we have obtained the value of focal length. But then why have we actually evaluated the value of focal length? Because the question never asked to determine the value of F. See, what happens is, in case of a concave or a convex mirror, the value of U is shifted. It also changes the, if the value of U is shifted, it also changes the value of V and hence the measurement of the magnification, the ratio of HI by HO. But one thing which remains constant is the focal length of a mirror. So we have obtained the value of F of this given mirror and this value of F will be used in the second part. So let us start with the second part. Now what the question says is, where should the object be placed, that is It is asking us to find out the value of u to get a magnification of 1 by 3. So in the second part, u is unknown. Magnification is again positive because it is talking about a convex mirror and m is positive for convex. Now, u is unknown, we have to find u, m is 1 by 3 and f, which we have obtained in the previous case, can be reused. No other value can be reused in the second case. We cannot use the value of v, we cannot reuse the value of u because this v and u were for the specific case when the magnification is half. So focal length is the only thing which can be reused. It is something which remains constant for a mirror. So f is 16. Now let us solve this. So magnification is minus v by u, which in this case is given to be 1 by 3. We have magnification as minus v by u is equal to 1 by 3. So we get u is equal to, I have shifted u that side, and u is equal to minus 3v, or I can say that v is equal to minus u by 3. So now we use the mirror formula, 1 by f is equal to 1 by v plus 1 by u. What we can do here is f is known to us, v is minus u by 3 now. So this relation becomes 1 upon 60, which is the focal length, and in place of v I can write minus u by 3. So this is minus u by 3 plus 1 upon u. Fine. So this is the relation. Using this relation you can find out the value of u now, which the question was asking. So when the magnification is 1 by 3, focal length 60, you can find out the value of u from this relation, and the value of u that you will obtain by calculating this will be minus 120 centimeter by solving this fraction. So that's all for this lecture. We will start with refraction in the next lecture. I hope you have understood all the tricks and all the formulae, all the relation, and how to approach a numerical based on spherical mirrors. Thank you.